Well, what's up, everybody? My name's Bryan O. This is The Hunt for the Good Stuff, and we're back with another episode here in sunny Miami. This week, you know I stay hungry, so I'm thinking Thai Tapas. Thai Tapas, you say, in Miami? Impossible to find? Not for the hunt. What we have here is Lung Yai, a little hidden place on Calle Ocho, Little Havana that nobody knows about. Check this place out. Welcome back, everybody. So we are in Museum Park. That's a big ass anchor. This place is awesome. It's in downtown Miami, and it's a great venue space for everything from Warped Tour to a 6 a.m. yoga session by the bay. This place is great if you just want to kind of get out, get a little sun, walk around, see some greenery. It's in downtown Miami. It's right by the water, and it's a great little getaway from the hustle and bustle of the city. Let's talk that food though, right? Crab and pork dry noodles, handmade egg noodles, roasted pork, lump crab meat, bean sprouts, Chinese broccoli, scallions, and cilantro. This thing was great. They dub it the dry noodle because everything else in the category seemed to be kind of soup-esque. You saw people just down the line enjoying like different items, and it was basically almost like a ramen setup. With this particular version, it's the dry noodle. The dry noodle actually has a little bit of sauce on the bottom. Now, I wonder if that's just kind of like the broth left over from the proteins, but it was great. So one of the key tricks here is to kind of mix everything in appropriately. You want to get everything equally wet and juicy. Those noodles are great. Texturally, they hit right on the spot. You want your baby back, baby back, baby back. Well, don't even mention chilies around me because you are no longer in the band. Now, if you want some baby backs, you come with me to Lung Yai. Now, Lung Yai's got these great ribs where they marinate them in a red bean paste. They deep fry the whole thing. There's like these little itty bitty bones inside, but they're so, so good. A little bit of cilantro on top adds a little color. Herbaceousness. The sauce on the side is one of my personal favorites. It's got a nice vinegary zip to it, but the heat component is right on the front. Like, you almost got to take it easy with it because it'll sneak up on you very, very quickly. All right, so next we need some greens in our life. What are we getting? Thai green curry. I know, not the vegetables that mom wants you to eat, but it's green, so I'm gonna say it's good for you. Thai classic curry in a light green sauce with eggplants, bamboo shoots, green peas, bell pepper, and basil leaves. They throw a little bit of rice on the side for you. You want some sweetness, coconut milk on deck. You want some palm sugar, it's already in there. A little bit of that fish sauce hidden within gives you that umami kick that just hits you from the blind side, like that QB blitz. It's really hard for me to go to one of these spots and not pick up some dumplings, so let's throw them on the side. You know, they're just kind of like a little like intermezzo, if you will. So we got some shrimp dumplings, deep fried, the soy vinaigrette, delicious. If you're talking about something that's so simple that you could get in like a supermarket and still enjoy, this is a super elevated version of it. They got the recipe down just right. The crispy duck salad, delicious. Now, the duck itself, it's not roasted, it's not pan fried, it's deep fried. The thing actually tastes like pork when all said and done, and they give you these beautiful strips. It's not so much a salad, some lettuce leaves on the side just kind of tether the idea of it being a salad, but realistically, it's a combination of that mountain of duck with red onions, scallions, cilantro, a little bit of that vinegar backbone to it as well. Those things are delicious, and if you're giving me anything above anything else in those ingredients, make sure that duck is stocked up for me, okay? Something interesting to note about this restaurant, it's small, it's intimate, it's busy. The thing is popping. We get there, there's like six people online. 2 minutes later, that number triples. They got these crazy soup Nazi rules, Seinfeld reference if you like. You could only order once, so you gotta throw it all down right from the jump. So don't be offended, go with the flow, and order with a bold heart. So, question of the week, what's your favorite item to order in a Thai restaurant? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you like the video, give me a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to hit that button to subscribe up top. You already know what I'm gonna say, don't you? You keep watching, I'm gonna keep hunting. You guys are awesome. See you soon.